بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. In كتاب البيوع إمام البخاري رحمه الله mentions a hadith wherein Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is addressing the companions and he says, from the previous nations there was a businessman. When the angel of death approached to take away his soul, the angel asked, is there any good deed that you have carried out? What good have you done? So the man replied, I do not know of any good deed that I have carried out, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given me wealth and I used to lend it to the people. So when it was time for them to pay me back, there were two categories of people, those who were able to, those who were also wealthy. When they would come, if they didn't have wealth with them, I would give them time to pay. So let's say a person had to pay him today or by the end of month and his time had come, but he didn't have the wealth. So this man would prolong that period of time. He would give them a longer grace period in order to pay. Or if they came with the wealth, but it was not complete. So for example, if they owed him $1,000 and this wealthy man only brought $950, the man would actually forgive that little bit that was remaining. As for the people who were poor or they weren't really well off, this man says that he would forgive them. He would tell those who were working for him that forgive them, look over it. Perhaps Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive me and look over my sins. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَتَجَاوَزَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave him. In this hadith, we see how a businessman who does not know of any good deed that he has carried out during his life, except one, and that was with regards to business, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually forgave him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looked over his sins. Look at how a person doing business, trying to make things easier for others, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually forgave his sin. In fact, there is a hadith that Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah mentions later on of a businessman who Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him glad tidings of Jannah, not once, but twice. Who was this man? This was Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu. The first time Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave him glad tidings for something that he had done with his wealth was when the Muslims came to Medina and there was no abundance of water to drink. There was one well that people had to buy water from. The person who owned the well didn't want to give it for free. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, whoever buys this well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant him Jannah. So Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu bought this well and he made it a waqf for the Muslims. So this was the first instance wherein Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu was granted or was given glad tidings of Jannah because of the well that he bought. The second instance was the Battle of Tabuk. The Muslims did not have a lot of camels and a lot of resources. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Man jahhaza jaysh al-usra falahu al-jannah." The person who actually provides for this army will be granted Jannah. It is mentioned that Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu, in some riwayat, he gave 1,000 gold coins and he also gave at least 300 camels which were fully equipped. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him glad tidings of Jannah for a second time. There were other times where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him glad tidings of Jannah, but these two instances were regarding something that he did with his wealth. The first is when he bought the well, and the second is when he provided for the army. When we look at this hadith, there is something we can ponder over. The first is, we all know that the goal of every Muslim is to attain Jannah. That is your goal in life. So imagine when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam announces to the people that whoever does a certain action, they will be granted Jannah. Surely everybody who is there would want to do it. But not everybody who is there has the capacity or is capable of doing it. When it came to this action or act of worship, we find that it was regarding wealth, spending wealth. And the only person at the time who was able to do that was Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu. Why? Because he was a businessman. He was one of the wealthiest Muslims to have ever lived, radiyallahu anhu. So look at how we saw in the previous episodes, a person who was honest when it came to dealing with other people's wealth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his dua. In today's episode, we saw how somebody who was easygoing and he would forgive people when they couldn't really pay back, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave him. And we saw how Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu was given glad tidings of Jannah, not once, but twice. And this shows us the virtue of earning halal wealth, even if it is a lot, no problem, as long as you are using it in a way that will please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bi-idhnillah, in the next episode, we will go over some of the ahadith that speak about the virtue of earning wealth with your own hand. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all goodness. Ameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.